efficiency is always key when you want to race a solar car.
I mean, it was the first victory for us as a club.
And how far we can actually go with today's technology.
We understood that reliability is really key for solar cars.
It brought us so much closer together in those stressful situations.
It is still a solar car that we built, so always anything can happen with those cars. The European Solar Challenge takes place on the circuit Zolder in Belgium, which is just around about 1 hour of driving from Aachen away. And the circuit Zolder used to be a Formula One track once, but now it's just a regular racetrack where different events are happening all over the year. When you do the European Solar Challenge, you don't just go there on the Saturday morning and then you do the race and you come back home to Aachen, but you really have to be there for like around about a week. We're arriving on Wednesday actually, then we have the static and the dynamic scrutineering, which is just checkups that our cars are confirmed with the regulations of the event. And then we have a qualifying where we can decide in which positions we start during the race. And then from Saturday at lunchtime till Sunday at lunchtime, we have the race itself of 24 hours. And afterwards, of course, we have the packing up and we're going home again.
At the European Solar Challenge, we are easily the biggest team. And then when on Friday, all the alumni showed up as well, we were over 60 people. And it was just amazing to see how many people put their everything into Sonnenwagen. And yeah, good experience.
At this year's European Solar Challenge, we did not only participate with one car, but this time we took two cars of the European Solar Challenge, the Covestro Photon and the Covestro Sonnenwagen, which participated in the World Solar Challenge 3 years ago.
During the European Solar Challenge, our two biggest opponents were Agoria, the Belgian team that won the World Solar Challenge in 2019, as well as Twente, the Dutch team that won the Moroccan Solar Challenge in 2021. So we were ready for some tough competition, and considering that we had 11 opponents, we really had to get the Photon ready and perform at its best.
Already when we arrived in Zolder, it was raining and there was rain forecast for the next few days, so we knew water was one of the main problems for the upcoming race. In the regulations of the European Solar Challenge, it's allowed to charge up to 3 times using a wall outlet pretty much. So that's the way how you can do a 24-hour race during night and even during very rainy conditions. Because we were quite well prepared when we arrived in Zolder, we had some time to think about what to improve on our car last minute. Normally, to charge the battery, we open the solar generator and connect the battery to our charger. But we introduced an additional charging port that could be accessed via one of the wheel covers, so we didn't need to open the solar generator to charge our car. And this allowed us to really seal the solar generator and don't get any water into the car.
Qualifying was much more exciting this year than during the past years. First, we had to drive a round of obstacles, and then secondly, we had to do a pit stop where we had to change our tire as fast as possible. And as we had two cars, the Photon and the Covestro Sonnenwagen, it really came down during practice of a competition of the alumni and the active team. And in the end, the Photon team only needed 22 seconds to change a tire, pushing us to first place during qualifying.
Because everything was prepared so well on Saturday morning, we really just had to get the car totally ready. We had to pack our battery so it was waterproof, and we had to close our solar lid as good as possible. And then we could roll on the racetrack and it was finally race time.
We started the European Solar Challenge! Go, 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 go!
A
few hours into the race, the weather cleared up a bit, and we decided to change to dry tires because they are way more efficient. We knew there was rain forecast later for the race, but we planned to drive a few hours on the dry tires to use the efficiency advantage of the tires. Unfortunately, the rain came back sooner as we expected, and the officials called out a wet race pretty soon, so we were forced to change back to rainy tires.
And that was super unfortunate for us, because again we had to drive into the pit lane, change the tires again. Now we are in fifth place. Super frustrating experience, because we had started off so well, and now with such a poor decision we lost our lead. Now the fight was really on. We had to get back from fifth place, wanting to be back in pole position. And within the stint that Jan did, one of our drivers, we fought back to get into second place. But Twente was way ahead of us, so we really, really had to keep on pushing.
We went in for our first charging break. We had a little situation right when we entered the charging area. We noticed our rear tire was completely flat. And unfortunately, it's not allowed to work on the car inside the charging area. And normally, it's not intended to push back the car through the pit lane. So we had a little discussion with the officials. And in the end, they allowed us to pump up the tire at the beginning of charging, and if the tire was empty at the end of charging, then we were allowed to push back the car. Otherwise, we would have to do one lap and come into the pit lane again. We did that. We pumped up the tire, and after half an hour, it was completely empty again. So the officials allowed us to push back our car to our pit box.
But it was raining so hard that I still remember that I ran into the pit box and I got some random blue foil I just found there out to somehow protect our driver and our solar cells from the rain that was coming down.
Over the whole night, the race was really close. We were head to head with Twente Red E, and we exchanged first position a few times. So it was really intense for the driving strategy and the rest of the team. After our second charging stop, unfortunately, Twente was in the lead a few rounds, and we didn't expect them to charge again. But nevertheless, we were trying to catch up. But at that point, we really were not sure if this was going to happen at all.
From the outside perspective, it really seemed like the rain was one of the main opponents for every single team during the race. For example, Twente had to leave the track every couple of hours, completely drying their car. Some of their aero protective covers couldn't be put on because they had their rain tires on. So all these things combined just meant that they had to stay out for a good amount of time during the morning hours, during which we were able to play catch up and manage to overtake them, putting us finally back into pole position.
At this point in the race, I was sitting at the strategy desk, and somebody came around and said, Twente is standing in front of their box and having some technical problems. And we had a look, and obviously they had some problem with the water inside of their car. So after half an hour, Twente was on the road again. They luckily fixed their car, but from that point on, they were really doing quite fast laps. Obviously, they saved some energy in the time they were standing in front of the pit box.
At that point in the race, the tension was really, really high, because it was just 2.5 hours till the race ended, And we were currently in first place, but Twente was in second place, just a few laps behind us. And they were driving faster than we were. So we didn't know how long they could last with that speed they had at the moment. If they would have kept up that speed for so long, they would have at some point overtaken us and would be back in first place.
And they just simply weren't charging. We didn't understand why they weren't charging. They had to run out of battery. And then they do the driver change, and usually you would expect them to charge at least then. And then they started going for run round, and then they came back inside because unfortunately they had battery issues. But that was the point where it was clear, okay, here we go, the Photon is going to win if it now continues for 2 hours straight. Keeping in mind it was still raining a lot, and we just had to make sure that these 2 hours were driven with a huge amount of concentration and the determination until the end. Because now it was also time for the Covestro Sonnenwagen to pick up speed, because now they had a real chance of becoming second. And I mean, to even consider having first and second place never crossed our mind. And then we won, easily one of the top five moments of my life. It was just so satisfying to see the Photon live up to its potential after all this hard work that we put in. Same with the Covestro Sonnenwagen. It really, really deserved the second place. And it just got to show how many people were involved since 2015, getting us up to speed. Super satisfying to show everyone that you can race during rain such hyper-efficient cars. And yeah, it will truly stay in my heart forever.
All our preparations pretty much played out. We had no technical problems during the race that kept us from driving, and the inside of the car was completely dry after we opened the solar generator after the race. And yeah, we managed to drive over 1,100 kilometers over the 24 hours.